Come one, come all, as I tell you the story of how we defended against the Marauder Order. It was a day like any other. We were minding our own business in Tinvine when we got word that Niflheim was under attack. We had made the mistake of not preparing for a potential attack, but nevertheless, we geared up quickly. We quickly left Tinvine with Cranberry of Bolvarad and Turkish of Tundril. As we snuck into the town, we told the other townsfolk to come out and join us in the fight. They were growing restless and eager to fight, awaiting for us to arrive. As we got closer, the Marauder saw us and ran away. We had the numbers to strike the fear of the volcano god into his soul. The battle didn't last for long. It was a short fight and a shorter victory. Within the next few hours, Falcon, the leader of Niflheim, came back saying that the so-called Marauder King came to seek revenge, but we weren't having it. So we geared up and made our way over. There were two of them this time, but our main focus was on the king. Quack, a friend of ours, was forced to help the king since he too was a marauder. Because of this, we told everybody that if Quack wanted to run away, let him. This now meant that the king was forced to hold his own against our forces. He was doing really well too, but he just kept making too many mistakes. Because of this, he couldn't hold out for much longer. The king's armor was slowly disappearing. At this point, it became a mental game where we had to wear him out, which eventually led to his demise. This is only the beginning, so if you want to fight in the war against Marauders, join play.orinlore.net and be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on any news or future videos that come out. And as always, I'll see you next time.